As a very general overview, when we're talking about training for hypertrophy, we're typically looking at something like 8 to 12 repetitions per set. Now, in the last 5 to 8 years, it has become extremely clear. Hypertrophy happens pretty equally from as low as 5 repetitions per set all the way up to 30 repetitions per set. So you can go anywhere in that window as long as you're training to the same effort and expect equal hypertrophy. But that said, most of the time, most people stick closer to kind of 8 to 12 repetitions, but by all means, go lower or higher, and it should be no problem at all, absolutely equally effective. What that means then in terms of intensity is that will scale based upon how heavy you're lifting. Generally, if you're in the kind of 8 to 12 repetition range, you're probably in the 70 to 80% of your one rep max range. If you were to go a little bit lower, say 5, 6 repetitions per set, you might be a little bit higher, maybe 80-85%. And if you're to go lower, in fact, you can go as low as 30% of your one repetition maximum. That's been shown extensively in the research, equally effective, but that would just require you to do 25 or 30 or potentially even more repetitions per set. I've talked about the pros and cons of this in other episodes and potentially will even next season go into the details. There are not the same because of things like strength. So while you will expect equal hypertrophy with, say, 25 repetitions per set as you would with 8 repetitions per set, the strength progress will not be the same. Strength needs to happen at a lower rep range so that you can get the intensity of the load high enough. Typically, what we're looking at there is, of course, what I've spoken of before, the 3 to 5 method, so 3 to 5 repetitions per set, but that could go a little bit higher. Really do remember, these are not hard cutoff lines. These are just kind of phased out. So if I can get strength at 5 repetitions per set, what do you think happens at 6? Still some strength. What about 7? Yeah, still some. 8? Yeah, sure. But what about at 30? Well, okay, very little. And so what happens is it's just kind of like, where is the general place to be most of the time? That's all we're saying with strength. But because of what we're trying to do, reach a high load, we have to have a low repetitions per set because fatigue starts to reduce the amount of weight we can actually lift. So strength is generally something, again, like 3 to 5 repetitions, plus or minus, can be as low as 1. If you want to truly peak strength, you do 1 repetition as heavy as you can. And there's cons to that as well. You want to go a little bit higher, 5, 6, 7 reps. Okay, still fine, but maybe you have to go a little bit lighter. Gives you rough context of what you're looking at. For power, just continue that logic one more step. So because power has a strength and velocity component, not only can I not afford to lose some force output, I can't afford to lose velocity either. And so power happens typically in a similar rep range, almost always though less than kind of 6 reps per set at the most, usually even less than that, right? 2 to 5, probably more so even than strength. And we have to do it at a fast speed. So the intensity, the load can't be as high because I have to move it fast. Okay, so while you could do something like this, say 3 sets of 3 repetitions at 95% of your bench press for strength, that's going to move very slow. And so that wouldn't be great at developing power. We would want to go to maybe 3 sets of 3 repetitions at 65%. So not super, super light, because now we're just working on pure speed, but not super heavy either, because now we're just working on pure force, somewhere in the middle. Every exercise has a different optimal load. In other words, how heavy you can lift, what percentage of your one rep max to maximize power. Generally, very generally, upper body, smaller exercises tend to achieve their peak power at a lighter percentage, 40% of your max, 50% of your max, maybe as low as 30% of your max. Bigger exercises like a squat, higher, maybe 50% of your max, 60% of your max. More complicated movements like a snatch or a clean and jerk can even be as high as like 80 to 95% of your one rep max. So it does vary a little bit, but the point with power always is it has to be a combination of heavy and fast. If it's fast and no load, it's speed but not power, which is okay too if that's what you're after. If it's heavy and very, very slow, it's force, which is okay, but it's not power either. Power needs to be somewhere in the middle. So with that in mind then, the rest range for hypertrophy can really be whatever you'd like. It can be as small as 30 seconds. Now, by doing that, you're going to accumulate more fatigue, which means you're either going to have to do less repetitions or less weight or a combination. But that's absolutely fine. It can be high rest. Even up to 5 minutes of rest have been shown to produce equal hypertrophy as 30 seconds. Obviously, if you go more rest, you get more recovery, which means we now need to keep the weight higher, go higher, and keep the rep range higher or go higher. And so pros and cons, there are subtle differences, but equal benefit from short rest ranges as low as 30 seconds all the way up to longer rest ranges up to 5 minutes. For strength and power though, it's a different story. You need to stay away for the most part of low rest intervals. Remember, this is all about quality. We need to practice moving fast a bunch of times. We need to practice moving heavy a bunch of times. If we shorten our rest intervals and we can't move as fast, we can't produce as much force, then we're not practicing producing force. And we're not practicing moving faster. And so we're really undercutting our adaptations. 2 to 5 minutes of rest is the rough recommendation for power and strength. But you do want to think about this in context. If I were to do, say, one vertical jump, I don't truly need to rest 5 minutes. That's not that fatiguing. I could probably honestly do 1 minute and be, depending on how fit you are, you might even be able to do like 40 seconds and be fine. And so they're just guidelines, okay? Think about the person. Think about what phase of training they're in. Early in a training phase, maybe you want more rest. But 16 weeks into a training program, you're very fit, you're very strong, you're in shape. You maybe don't necessarily need a full extensive rest interval to produce peak power again. Okay. If you're trying to maximize, truly maximize your strength, you're probably going to take 5+ minutes of rest. If you're trying to work on a lot of different repetitions on a lot of exercises of power, maybe 2 minutes is good. Oftentimes when I say that, people are like, oh my God, 5 whole minutes. And they go to the gym, they do it, they start their clock, and like 30 seconds in, they're like, oh my gosh, like I have to wait another 4.5 minutes. Well, not necessarily all the time and not for every exercise. I will caution though, you are not nearly as recovered as you think you are. If you're used to doing things that are like moderate strength or hypertrophy or muscular endurance, you're not really understanding and you typically can't register what it feels like to be at 100%. You get to kind of 90, 92% and you think, yeah, I don't feel any difference. In this particular case, if we're trying to maximize power and strength, that last 7% matters, but you may not be able to perceive it if you're not used to it. And so typically what I'd say is if you're not used to this type of training, I would still take more rest intervals than you think you want to. What's the harm? You cost yourself an extra 6 minutes combined at the end of the workout by doing 20 more seconds of rest. Okay, you can live with that, okay? If eventually you realize that's enough and you want to back it back down, that's great. But initially start off with more rest than you think. For the most part, people err on the side of too short when it comes to power and strength, not necessarily too long.